Hello, I am Hiren Taylor and welcome back to Arduino Programming and Interfacing. In this video, I am going to tell you about the DHT11 module that is helpful to measure the temperature and the humidity. So here you can see that this module have a 3 pin, and at my left hand side it is a positive pin which is going to be connected to the plus 5 volt, and this out pin is going to be connected with the Arduino pin. Similarly, in the end, we have the ground pin which is need to be connected to the ground. So here you can see that I have interfaced this out pin to the pin number 8 of the Arduino, and we want to display the temperature and humidity on the LCD screen. In my previous video, I have already explained how to interface the LCD with the Arduino. So you can see the setup that I have created in the previous video. To interface this LCD with Arduino, I have connected this D4 to D7 pin to the pin number 5 to 2 of the Arduino, and the pin RS and enable is connected to the pin number 12 and 11 respectively, and similarly the other pin for the supply and the ground is connected to the respective point. I have provided the link for LCD interface video in the description. Now I'm going to interface this DHT11 module to the Arduino board. So you can see that I'm connecting these three wires to the module. So these are the three wires, and this black wire is a ground, so I'm connecting it to the ground. This red wire is a supply, so I am connecting it to 5 volt supply, and this yellow wire is a data or output, so we are going to connect to the pin number 8 of the Arduino. So interfacing of DHT11 to the Arduino is done. Now let's starting with the programming. So to program this DHT module, you need to include the DHT library in this Arduino. So to check this DHT library, you can see in the include library, and here you can see that there is no DHT library present. So what we can do is we can click on manage libraries, and it will open the library manager. After that, search DHT. So it will show the result related to the DHT library, and then select this simple DHT library by WinLin. You can select the different version over here. So just select the version and click on install. So you can see that we have successfully installed library. So now to verify that we have successfully installed DHT library, just click on sketch and go to the include library, and then see here we have the simple DHT library. So just click on it, so it will include the simple DHT.header file in our program. So next we want to display our result on the LCD screen, so I will write include, then liquid crystal.h, so that will include the header file for the liquid crystal. And similarly we need to define the pin also, so for that I will use constant integer RS equal to 12, enable equal to 11, then D4 which is connected to pin number 5, then D5 which is connected to pin number 4, then we have D6 which is connected to pin number 3, and D7 which is connected to pin number 2. So you can change this pin, but you have to make the change in the hardware also. And finally, to inform this microcontroller, we will use liquid crystal LCD, and then we will define all these variables. So enable D4, D5, D6 and D7. Similarly, we have connected our DHT module on pin number 8, so I will use the integer pin DHT 11 that is equal to 8. So it will assign the pin number 8 to integer pin DHT 11. And we will also use simple DHT 11 variable, and for that we have DHT 11. Now in void setup, I will write lcd.begin 16,2. So we have used the 16x2 LCD, so it is lcd.begin 16,2, 16 column and the 2 rows. And let's jump to void loop. So here we will write our logic. So first of all, I will define temperature using byte. Initially it will be a 0. Similarly, using byte we will define humidity, it is again 0, and then I will define integer err variable for the error, and it will be a simple DHT err success. Now let's compare the variable with our value. So for that we will use if err equal to DHT 11 dot read. So this will read from the our pin number 8. So I will write pin DHT 11 that we have defined as pin DHT 11 comma, and it will get the value of temperature comma and humidity comma null. So this value is not equal to simple DHT err success. So I have made mistake over here, so let me change SUCC, and we will complete the parenthesis. So here you can see that we will compare the value. So if the measured value, if it is not equal to the this value that we have defined, so we will consider this as an error and we will display the error message. So for that I will write, so in this loop we will write the message for the error. So first of all, I will provide the delay of 1 second so that sensor can measure the value, and after that use lcd dot clear. We will clear the LCD, whatever that is written in the previous operation it will be clear, and then lcd dot set cursor to 0,0 position. So it will start from first column and the first row, and let's write our message to be print, that is lcd.print. Now we want to print the message that there is some error, so I will write error. So if this value, if measure value is not equal to this, then it will display the error message. In the end, after that we have to also return it, so I will write return. And after this loop we will define, let's say we have the perfect measure value, so it will continue lcd dot clear. LCD dot again set cursor to 0 comma 0. Then we will write lcd.print. Now we will print the message for the temperature. So I will write first temp, then let's write colon and give some space, again double inverted comma over, and this will print the temp on the first row. After that we want to print the value of the temperature, so I will write lcd dot print integer. So we want to print the value in integer, so I will write int integer and then variable temperature and then bracket over. So this will print the value of temperature. And finally we want to show the degree Celsius also, so I will print lcd dot print we will use a character and the value is for centigrade, value is 223, so it will show the symbol of degree. LCD print. Now we will write C, so it will, now it will be like temperature, that will be equal to the value, and then degree and C for the centigrade. Similarly, on another line, that is on the second line, we will display the value of humidity. So I will write lcd dot set cursor to 0, 1, so it will take the value to the second row. And then let's print our message. So lcd dot print, now we want to print the humidity, so I will write humidity, again colon and space, again lcd dot print. Now we want to print in integer also, so again write int and humidity variable, so it will print the measured value of the humidity. And in the end we will write lcd dot print. Humidity is displayed in percentage, so I will mention the percentage sign over here. And finally we will provide some delay, let's say we will provide the delay of 0.75 second, and that's it. We have almost complete the our programming, and let's verify it. So just click on verify, so it will ask us to save the file, so I will write as DHT11 and click on save. Now you can see that it is right now compiling the sketch, so it's now done compiling. So now I'm going to connect this cable to the laptop, so you can see that right now it is showing the previous message. And now let's upload this code to the Arduino, so I will click on upload. So you can see that it shows the temperature is 27 degree and humidity is 46%. So it will continuously update this value at every interval of 0.75 second. So if I will remove this pin number 8 and check what happened, So you can see that it will shows the error message. That means the DHT is not getting the value. So again, let me connect this to pin number 8, and you can see that we have the humidity according to the situation. So to vary the humidity, just let me cover the sensor and we will check that what happened to the humidity. So you can see that humidity is varying now. As I have covered this sensor, and the temperature is also increased by the 1 degree. Let me take back to normal position. We can see that again the humidity is now normal. So this is how you can use the DHT sensor to measure the temperature and the humidity, and you can display the value on the LCD. See you next time with some more programming and interfacing. Thanks for watching.